When people hear the name Marco Polo, they tend to think of a map maker and an explorer. Very few people know that the true story of Marco Polo is so much more compelling and exciting than the mythology.
At the beginning of the story, Marco is 17 years old. His father was a great merchant, so his dream is to become a great merchant as well.
Marco travels with his father on his next trip back to China.
They get to the court of Kublai Khan, and when the negotiation goes wrong, as a last-ditch effort, the father offers Marco service.
Father, what are you doing? I am your son.
Am I a privileged guest or a prisoner?
We are all prisoners and privileged guests, one and the same.
He was this young guy when he arrived in China, in this world of concubines and court intrigue and danger.
Marco has this passion for people and cultures, and he falls in love with this amazing world.
Kublai described him as having uncommon powers of perception.
You have a clever mind for a Latin.
He valued this, and he gave him an education. He prepared him to be an emissary.
Marco finds in Kublai a sort of father with a lot of things that he can teach to him.
Marco Polo was an Italian. He's a fearless global traveler, and so was Lorenzo. So he tapped into it.
Marco Polo, what does that mean?
The great explorer.
He has this brooding quality, but also this fire.
If you're lying, I will come back.
He is that perfect balance between storyteller and badass warrior.
Marco's stories are so legendary that there's a lot to explore, but it's also so fascinating because it is partially legend and partially historical.
We are going to take audiences on an action-packed Silk Road journey.